the Schindler Laboratory, we study reproductive biology, and we're interested in determining the molecular mechanisms that leads to aneuploidy in oocytes using a mouse model system. When eggs and sperm are made, they undergo a very special process called meiosis. And what this means is that they end up with one copy of every chromosome from a starting precursor cell. And this is so that after fertilization, the end result is an embryo, and then eventually a child, that has the normal number of chromosomes in it. But what can happen during meiosis is that when those chromosomes are being segregated to produce the number of them, there can be mistakes. And these mistakes will end up in a gain or a loss in the number of chromosomes that the sperm or egg could contain. One very well-known situation where this occurs is called Down syndrome, where the resulting embryo gets three copies of chromosome number 21. It just so happens that in females, this segregation mistake is much more prevalent than it is in males. So sperm appear to do meiosis very well, but eggs do not. And we're really curious as to why that is. So our research really focuses at the molecular level at understanding how this process is regulated so that it can occur properly, so that we can understand these mistakes better at the molecular level. Using the mouse model is actually a very powerful system for us in understanding human reproductive biology. Eggs in women are very precious and they're very rare. Women are born with a finite number of eggs that they will have, and we only have them for a certain part of our life. So it makes them very hard to obtain and work with. There's a lot of ethical considerations in working with human eggs. And it's also very invasive to get eggs from women to do the sorts of studies that we're interested in. And so the mouse is a really great model because it's a mammal. Humans are mammals. And so the genes and that process of meiosis are actually very similar between mouse and humans. And so it's a very robust model for us to work with. And we also get a lot more eggs from a mouse than we would from a human. One of the really powerful things that we can do in our system is once we isolate the eggs from the mouse, we can actually manipulate them outside of the animal, or in culture is what we call it. And we can actually introduce any material that we want to in that egg by a microinjection process. And that way we can actually perturb or disturb a process that we're interested in by introducing materials into the egg, and then ask, what have we done to meiosis in the end result of those experiments? You know, one out of six couples in the U.S. face struggles with infertility. Some couples' problems can be solved in the clinic through in vitro fertilization or other types of assisted reproductive technologies. But the fact is the vast majority of these couples' struggles actually can't be solved by these technologies as they are currently. And that's not very appreciated in the media and in society, because those are typically the problems that aren't discussed. What my research is really aimed at understanding is why in females there's these elevated levels of aneuploidy. There are patients who fail in successfully conceiving in the in vitro fertilization clinics because their levels of aneuploidy are extremely high. And so after many failed attempts of doing these types of technologies, at the end you don't have any normal embryos to transfer back, you're not going to have a successful pregnancy. And so what I hope through our research is to understand at a very basic level how this process occurs, and then to take our research the next step and look at these patients who have these elevated aneuploidy levels and see if some of the regulators that we're interested in studying could be problematic in these women, and ask if we could develop ways to have better screening so that couples that have this problem could know, you know, this is going to be your specific challenge in the clinic. And then even further down the road, maybe have some therapeutics to be able to assist these couples in conceiving children.